Welcome to The Intersection. I am Konya Obaji. Thank you for joining us. Today, we begin the show by examining the liberation of Raqqa and what that means for the movement for a Kurdistan state. Between 25 and 35 million Kurds inhabit a mountainous region straddling the borders of southeastern Turkey, northeastern Syria, northern Iraq, northwestern Iran, and southwestern Armenia. They make up the fourth largest ethnic group in the Middle East, but they have never obtained a permanent nation state. So why is there talk of Kurdistan state in the wake of the liberation of the city of Raqqa in Syria? In early 2014, the Islamic State made Raqqa, Syria, the headquarters of its self-styled caliphate, implementing an extreme interpretation of Islamic law and using beheadings, crucifixions, and torture to terrorize residents who opposed its rule. The city also became home to thousands of jihadists from around the world who heeded a call to migrate there by ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. But the rise of ISIS and the prospect of fighting and defeating them presented the Kurds with an opportunity to claim victory over a universal threat on the world stage and to reshape the region to perhaps include Kurdistan. It is not just the Kurds. With such a calculation, scenarios are rapidly being plotted by every group that has played a role in Iraq and Syria over many years of war and loss. Russia, the United States, and Iran are jostling for advantage across the swath of both countries held by ISIS. The prize is far more than who gets to claim the inevitable military victory over ISIS. At stake for all sides is the future makeup of the region and a chance to shape it in their likeness. So in 2015, the Kurdish forces known as the Syrian Democratic Forces, independent of Syrian President Bashar al-Assad and independent of the rebels seeking to overthrow President Assad, made it their mission to fight ISIS and recapture ISIS territory. With the help of US-led coalition airstrikes, weapons, and special forces, Kurdish forces have done just that, driven ISIS out of ISIS' stronghold city of Raqqa and other territories. The Kurdish-led forces now control Raqqa, and Kurdish-led authorities in other parts of northern Syria are already discussing plans to establish a federal system in areas they control in Iraq, Turkey, Iran, Armenia, and Syria. However, Syrian President Bashar al-Assad, who is regaining territory with Iranian and Russian military support, has said the state will recover control over the entire country, including the city of Raqqa. So here is a twist. Amid the great power struggles between Russia, Iran, Syria, and the US, the Kurds too have sensed opportunity in chaos. Turkey, opposed to a Kurdistan state, has deployed its military to an area adjacent to Raqqa in an attempt to rein in the Kurdish forces on behalf of Syria, Russia, and Iran. The sectarian tension that could arise from all of this could plague the Middle East for years to come, possibly expanding into a proxy conflict among various international groups. Additionally, the Islamic State, after losing ground, may revert to its insurgency roots and refocus on orchestrating terrorist attacks around the world. But let's provide some background to help contextualize all of this. In recent decades, Kurds have increasingly influenced regional development, fighting for autonomy in Turkey and playing prominent roles in the conflicts in Iraq and Syria, where they have resisted the advance of the so-called Islamic State jihadist group. Today, they form a distinctive community, united through race, culture, and language, even though they have no standard dialect. They also adhere to a number of different religious and creeds, although the majority are Sunni Muslims. In the early 20th century, many Kurds began to consider the creation of a homeland generally referred to as Kurdistan. After World War I and the defeat of the Ottoman Empire, the victorious Western allies made provisions for a Kurdish state in the 1920 Treaty of Sevres. Such hopes were, however, dashed 3 years later. However, when the Treaty of Lausanne, which set the boundaries of modern Turkey, made no provisions for a Kurdish state and left Kurds with minority status in their respective countries, Iraq, Syria, Armenia, Iran, Over the next 80 years, any move by Kurds to set up an independent state was brutally quashed. However, the rise of ISIS posited the case for Kurdistan in the military light. In 2013, ISIS turned its sights on three Kurdish enclaves that bordered its territory in northern Syria. It launched repeated attacks and made advances in Iraq and Syria. This drew the Kurds into the conflict. So in January 2015, after a battle that left at least 1,600 people dead and more than 3,200 buildings destroyed or damaged, Kurdish forces regained control of cities and towns once overrun by ISIS. Since then, the Kurds have inflicted a series of defeats on ISIS in northern Syria with the help of US-led coalition air power. They have established control of a stretch of contiguous territory along the Kurdish border and taken over ISIS stronghold of Raqqa. Fighting under the banner of the Syrian Democratic Forces, the Kurds have emerged as a key ally of the US-led coalition, which considers it one of the few effective partners on the ground in Syria. But here are the major concerns. Now that Raqqa is liberated, external military intervention, including the provision of arms and military equipment, training, airstrikes, and even troops in support of proxies in Syria, threatens to prolong a conflict already in its sixth year. The role of outside actors, namely Russia, Iran, Turkey, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, and the US-led coalition, complicates the conflict further. My take. The United States and the international coalition has sought to regain territory taken by the Islamic State and to dismantle their terrorist network. There is a larger concern that multiple players of different interests in the wake of ISIS fall. The wish list of outcomes is broad and divergent. For Russia, there is a chance to establish a presence in the center of the region with political muscle and enhanced gas and oil interests. For Iran, a consolidated and potentially decisive role in both countries is what it wants. And for the US, in the absence of a broader strategy, the chance to spoil its rivals' plans is what it seeks. That means the Kurds, who offer a progressive democratic alternative, could leverage their role in defeating ISIS and parlay US support into broader autonomy and perhaps a Kurdistan state. The Kurds of Iraq and Syria have made little attempt to hide the fact that the post-ISIS vacuum marks a rare, potentially historic moment for them to leverage their role into broader autonomy and perhaps a Kurdistan state. Apart from being an effective force, though, against ISIS, the Kurdish-led autonomous government are perhaps the only political alternative to the repressive Assad regime and the violent Islamic State. What do you think? We would like to hear your thoughts on this conflict and your ideas on how this can be resolved or curtailed. Thanks for watching. See you next time on The Intersection. I am Konya Obaji. So if you liked this video, subscribe to our channel, follow us on Twitter, and like us on Facebook.